Donald Trump has insisted there was blame on both sides during the Charlottesville clashes that left a 32-year-old woman dead in a February news conference at Trump Tower in New York. The U.S. president also defended himself against criticism that he was slow to condemn the violence. He told reporters he had wanted to get all the facts before he made his second stronger statement, in which he called neo-Nazis and white supremacist Republicans. The statement I made on Saturday, the first statement, was a fine statement, but you don't make statement that direct unless you know the fact. It takes a little while to get the fact, said Mr. Trump. The president's first statement with climate many sides were involved and stopped short of specifically condemning the firewalls widely criticized, facing a barrage of questions on Tuesday. A combative Mr. Trump again insisted not all the facts were known and that anti-right-wing protesters were also very violent and came charging with clubs. You had a group on one side that was bad. You had a group on the other side that was also very violent. Nobody want to say that. You say it right now, the president said. Sky US correspondent Cordelia Lin said Mr. Trump was clearly frustrated as reporters pursued him over the Charlottesville issue. Lin said the president effectively undid part of the statement that he issued yesterday with his shooting from the hip performance, shortly after Mr. Trump remarked. Speaker of the House Paul Ryan tweeted, "We must be clear, white supremacy is repulsive. This bigotry is counter to all these countries stand for. There can be no moral ambiguity." Peter Iyer, 32, was killed and 19 were injured when a man allegedly deliberately dropped his car at a crowd as protester face off in the Virginia City at the weekend. Mr. Trump called the man arrested, James Alex Fielder, a disgrace to himself, his family and this country, but declined to call the act terrorism. Protester, including from the Farai, had got her in Charlottesville over the removal of a statue of General Robert E. Lee, head of the Proslavery Confederate Army in the Civil War, Mr. Trump sat on the statue debate and challenged reporter to say whether statue of some American president should also be pulled out if they had outslapped. I wonder if it is George Washington next week and Thomas Jefferson the week after, he asked. The fallout from Mr. Trump's first statement has seen a number of high-profile business people step down from a government advisory group, and following his latest news conference, AFL-CIO President Richard Trumka became the fifth member of Mr. Trump's manufacturing job council to quit. The controversy appears far from dying down, especially with figures such as former Ku Klux Klan leader David Duke welcoming the president's latest word. He tweeted, "Thank you President Trump for your honesty courage to tell the truth about Charlottesville condemn the leftist terrorists in Bermantifa."